Back in October 1989, a NASA spacecraft that was named after the famous astronomer Galileo launched into space, beginning a 14-year mission that would reveal the solar system's largest planet like never before. The mission involved over 800 people from multiple countries and achieved many firsts, including being the first spacecraft to orbit an outer planet, being the first to deploy an entry probe into an outer planet's atmosphere, and being the first to closely image an asteroid. Galileo's journey to Jupiter started when it was released from the cargo bay of Space Shuttle Atlantis while in orbit around the Earth. Because the spacecraft did not carry enough fuel for a direct trip to the giant gas planet, it was set on a cleverly designed flight path that would take it hurtling past Venus once and Earth twice, in order to increase its speed and propel it outwards into the solar system, a technique known as a gravity assist maneuver. Galileo reached our shrouded neighbour, Venus, in February 1990, presenting the first opportunity for the spacecraft to properly test and calibrate its scientific instruments. It studied the thick Venusian clouds as it swung past the hellish planet, sending back fascinating images of its toxic atmosphere. This dark, almost eerie image exposes the planet's thick clouds as they circle above a scorching surface. The image was captured 5 days after Galileo's closest approach and was taken through a violet filter and coloured blue to enhance the contrast, allowing us to see the structure of the clouds in much greater detail. After gaining a boost from Venus, Galileo made its way home, where it would complete two more gravity assist flybys, the first taking place in December 1990. During the first flyby, Galileo captured this magnificent true color image when it was around 1.5 million miles away, which is 2.4 million kilometers away. You can see Africa stretching upwards from the center of our majestic planet, while the sunlit continent of Antarctica silently sits at the bottom, all of which is being slightly shrouded by swirling clouds. Close-up images of Earth were also captured, such as this beautiful bird's-eye view of Antarctica during the day as the darkness of night rolls in from the side. You can see the thin envelope of Earth's bluish atmosphere as it follows the curvature of the planet, a reminder of how fragile our existence really is. After passing Earth, the spacecraft swung outwards on an ever-growing orbit, and in October 1991, it clipped the edge of the asteroid belt, a vast region between Mars and Jupiter. Within this mysterious region, Galileo was able to make history by snapping the first ever close-up images of an asteroid. Named Gaspra, this asteroid is roughly 11 miles long, which is 18 kilometers long, and is a heavily pockmarked object that may have a relatively recent origin. The sun's light, which is shining from the right-hand side of the image, is clearly illuminating the asteroid's surface features, causing dark shadows to cast across its scarred, cratered landscape. But there seems to be a lack of larger craters, and scientists think this could indicate that Gaspra was once a part of a much larger body that was broken up during a catastrophic collision event. Once past Gaspra, Galileo swung inwards for its next encounter with Earth, and in December 1992, it successfully completed the second flyby, boosting its velocity for the last time and saying goodbye to its home planet forever. Now Galileo had finally built up enough speed to start its long journey to the outer solar system, where it would eventually begin its primary mission. But before it would arrive at Jupiter, it would first encounter one more object, and in August 1993, the spacecraft passed a second asteroid with a small surprise. Named Ida, this asteroid is the first ever to be discovered to have its own moon, which was later named Dactyl. The enormous asteroid is about 35 miles long, which is 58 kilometers long, while its little companion is just 1 mile across, which is 1.6 kilometers across. Where Dactyl originated from is uncertain, but scientists think that it is likely a fragment of a much larger object that broke apart at some point in the past. After passing Ida and Dactyl, Galileo continued on its long journey, eventually leaving the asteroid belt and entering the final stages of its trip. From here, the spacecraft had no more planned encounters before arriving at the gas giant, but it was able to capture a historic moment from a distance. In July 1994, the spacecraft was perfectly positioned to watch 21 fragments of comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 crash into Jupiter. It was able to make a direct observation of the impact and send back stunning images. These four frames were captured at the moment part of the comet collided, smashing into Jupiter's cloud tops with an estimated force of 300 million atomic bombs. Since it launched, Galileo visited Venus, swung by Earth twice, and encountered two separate asteroids, as well as getting a front row seat to a comet versus Jupiter showdown. After a journey that spanned 6 years and 2.3 billion miles, or 3.7 billion kilometers, Galileo had finally arrived at Jupiter. During its journey, Galileo also carried a small atmospheric probe that was released in July 1995 as the spacecraft entered its final approach. The probe made a solo flight into Jupiter's atmosphere, slicing through the clouds and descending for 95 miles, which is 153 kilometers for 58 minutes before being vaporized. Although the probe wasn't equipped with a camera, it did collect direct data on Jupiter's local weather for the first time. It recorded wind speeds of up to 450 miles per hour, which is 724 kilometers an hour, and detected huge thunderstorms in the distance that were many times larger than those we see here on Earth. Galileo successfully entered into orbit around Jupiter in December 1995, marking the start of its primary mission. Over the next 8 years, it orbited the gas giant and captured thousands of incredible images of the planet's mesmerizing atmosphere, including the famous storm, the Great Red Spot. The orbit was also designed so that the spacecraft could complete close-up flybys of Jupiter's largest moons, starting with the spectacular icy world, Europa. Magnificent images such as this one allowed us to view Europa in all its glory as it flaunted its fascinating surface features. They display a world with a diverse geology covered in long linear cracks and ridges that crisscross around the moon's icy crust, a crust that Galileo also discovered is hiding a subsurface liquid ocean. Close-up, fascinating features such as these reddish-coloured shallow pits, named lenticuli, which is Latin for freckles, were also spotted. The unusual holes are thought to be caused by warmer ice moving upwards from the bottom of Europa's ice shell, churning away like a frigid lava lamp, and of course providing further evidence of that concealed warm ocean. Scientists found that Europa's linear ridges and bands that crisscross its frozen surface are likely caused by Jupiter's strong gravity stretching and pulling the moon, which opens and closes ridges repeatedly, resulting in these astonishing, huge fractures. After Europa, in September 1997, during Galileo's 10th orbit of the gas planet, the bizarre moon Io was observed, a moon with a hellishly active surface. Io is the solar system's most volcanic world, as can be seen in this incredible color image. You can see irregular-shaped mountains, layered materials that form vast plateaus, and lava flows erupting from enormous pits, all spread out across a bright, sulfur-rich surface. Close-up images such as this one reveal beautiful colours mixing together within a volcanic depression that has been named Tupanpatera after the Brazilian thunder god. cooling lava is visible as black material, while the yellow is presumed to be a mix of sulfurous compounds, and the red is possibly sulfur gas that has condensed and coated the ground after escaping volcanic vents. All of which is surrounded by cliffs 3,000 feet tall, which is 900 meters tall. This image captures an active volcano in action as it erupts hot lava out onto Io's bizarre surface. Io's volcanic activity is a result of the strong gravitational pull from Jupiter on one side and the large moons Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto on the other. This gravitational tug of war stretches and bends Io, causing it to heat up inside and erupt the colorful materials that Galileo captured all those years ago. Over the 8 years that the spacecraft spent orbiting Jupiter, it captured hundreds of fascinating images of its largest moons, including Ganymede and Callisto. Ganymede, which is the solar system's largest moon, has an icy surface that is speckled with bright young craters, old darker craters, and a frozen terrain that is laced with strange grooves and ridges. Below this hard shell of ice, much like Europa, scientists think an ocean layer also exists that may contain more water than here on Earth. Callisto is Jupiter's second largest moon, and is the most heavily cratered object in the solar system, as these images reveal. The dark, icy, pummeled world clearly displays a long, violent history, although just like its neighbors, there is some evidence to suggest that it too might be hiding a liquid ocean deep below its frozen crust. The Galileo spacecraft completed 34 orbits of Jupiter while capturing thousands of stunning images of its clouds, rings, and mighty moons. Since it launched back in October 1989, it traveled a total of 2.8 billion miles, which is 4.6 billion kilometers, and made multiple discoveries during its 14 years exploring space. But like all things in life, the mission had to come to an end, and in September 2003, the spacecraft was commanded to deliberately plunge into Jupiter's atmosphere, destroying it forever and eliminating any chance of contamination between the craft and one of Jupiter's large moons. The Galileo mission remains one of the most successful missions ever undertaken. It revealed our solar system's largest planet in astonishing detail and provided the ambitious minds of planet Earth with a stepping stone into the future.